What's up, guys? I'm Shay.
And I'm Mr. Whippy.
And today, we'll be checking out If I Ever Fall in Love featuring Jason Derulo. Jason Derulo. By Pentatonix. Was that pure quality passion?
I swear, down a few years, you're just gonna shout out at the fucking camera. Pentatonix!
If I Ever Fall in Love by Shy, some 90s R&B. Have you heard the original song?
Never heard of it.
I used to listen to the song on the daily. Certain songs I would just have on repeat. This was one on the young puppy love stage in my life. I noticed a lot of pentaholics actually never heard the original. But you know, that's just the youth, you know? Young puppy pentaholics. See how I come up with my own names. I saw this music video drop within 20 minutes. Obviously not within 10 hours because I am not a patron. Isn't that right, Steven? So when I saw this, it dropped at a ridiculous time. So I decided to comment on the video. And what did I say? That was a subliminal to let you guys know who watched my reactions. That, yes, I know. And my reaction is on its way. But do I still get requests for it? Am I not a pentaholic? Am I not subscribed to their channel? Do I not follow them on Twitter? All five of them and the official page? So, of course, there's no way in hell I would know they'd drop the music video. Oh. Isn't that right? I'm oblivious. Like, I just need the constant reminders. Every time they drop a video, just let me know. Not just once. I mean, a million times. Now, I know I sound ungrateful. I'm just saying, though. Just saying. I still like the original to the song. Because no matter how good Pentatonix and Jason sing the song, you can't duplicate the 90s feel and sound. That's what makes the original sound so fucking good. Their cover is amazing. They killed it. I mean, they out-sing Shy in the song. And I still somewhat prefer the original. So I'm well aware of what the song sounds like. I'm just watching it for the visuals. I don't even think you've heard the original or the cover. See, that's that young blood right there. That's that young pentaholicism right there.
That insulted me. Calling me a pentaholic. Nah, jokes. Love you guys. As you were.
If you no longer want Mr. Whippy in these reactions just because of the way he talks to you guys, treats you guys on camera, let me know. I'll give him a few double backhands off camera. Let's check it out.
Speaker's gone blow.
Jesus. Ghostbusters, eh? Holy shit. It's not right without my name in there, eh? I didn't get my shit together, put my name on a page from the list. Hey.
Yeah.
Before I say anything, can we please, pretty please, give it up for Kirsten Maldonado one time? That outfit was amazing.
You're right. What a bottle of water. You gotta just relax a bit. Just calm down a bit. Calm the nerves a bit.
I'm dehydrated. Where's the hot stuff? Oh, it's passed us the vodka, Jay. I know that cover very well. And I've heard it many times. Because believe it or not, I'm pretty sure I was one of the first people to cop this album. I know I said I prefer the 90s version more just because that is the original song. Is that the original song? I don't think they remade that song. But this is just so much more powerful, you know? So much more energy and emotion. I knew Jason could sing.
I actually didn't.
JD. I'm gonna call him JD. But on this song, I didn't realize he could hit those high notes. When I was listening to this for the first time, I'm like, who's gonna hit that high note? Who was gonna do it? I thought it was gonna be Mitch. And at first, I thought it was Mitch, but I listened to it closely. I'm like, no, that's not Mitch. That must be fucking JD. The homie JD. He killed it. But in saying that, that hand though, I didn't appreciate that. I'm glad to have not seen that hand appear in this video like that. So I appreciate that very much, Jason.
Telling him off.
Hey, someone has to tell him where to go. Oh, Jeremy's not gonna do it all. Jeremy's not gonna do it all. Jeremy's not gonna do it all. They all killed it.
All I can say is they blew it out of the park once again. It's like, there's not a video that they just, you know,
well, it's impossible for them to not.
Yeah.
It's just you can't expect anything else.
No.
That's the least you expect for them to fucking blow your ears away. I like how they're all dressed in white as well. Pure. Kirsten Maldonado. Pure. Jesus. Pure. Jesus. What does he really use to say? Other than repeating myself in every video. I still love Scott's voice. Second most.
Jeez, what can't he sing? Like, I mean, the fuck?
But in saying that, so I still good. Like Avi's voice as well when he sings those high notes, when he's not, you know, doing his whole bass thing. Even Kevin, you know, we've seen
that's some so random, yeah.
Yeah, we've seen some videos where he can really sing. And we already know Mitch can fucking out-sing anyone. Just all comes down to preference now, eh? Kirsten Maldonado will forever be my number one preference. And I say that with the most sincerity and humbleism.
Humbleism.
Is that a word?
Pretty sure it's not.
Well, we just added that to the dictionary. Shea Bay's dictionary. And that's all I got to say about that. That video was Ka-Poi.
Ka-Poi.
If you don't know what that means.
It means very good.
Ka-Poi.
Ka-Poi.
Anyway, see you in the next video. The beginning though, you know what it looked like?
What?
They were in prison. With the shadows.
It's very subliminal.
It looked like they were locked up. It's almost like if I was taken away because of certain actions that came from me towards a person in particular, because of his current relations, me being locked up, thinking about whether I will ever fall in love again.
Wow.
My friend.